हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज मिसेस कुलकर्णी एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द 7th चैप्टर ऑफ 10th स्टैंडर्ड हिस्ट्री, दैट इज स्पोर्ट्स एंड हिस्ट्री. ओके, सो दिस इज हाउ व्हाट आर द टॉपिक्स वी आर गोइंग टू सी इन दिस चैप्टर, दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स, टाइप्स ऑफ स्पोर्ट्स, ग्लोबलाइजेशन, देन गेम मटेरियल्स एंड टॉयज, एंड टॉयज आर देयर, देन देयर हिस्ट्री, देन लिटरेचर एंड मूवीज ऑन द स्पोर्ट, देन स्पोर्ट्स एंड प्रोफेशनल अपॉर्चुनिटीज. See, the basic is what is sport. See, sport is a combined entertainment and a physical exercise. ठीक है. In the last class we have seen, the last chapter we have seen entertainment and history, where even sport is a part of, you know, the type of entertainment or the source of entertainment. What is source of, what's entertainment? Like the thing in which you are involved, which will make you fresh, feel good. Okay. And that sport is a type of entertainment. In that physical exercise is involved, and the advantage of sports is that it will improve your performance. Okay, it will improve your physical strength. It will increase your physical personality. It will improve your personality. Okay, the sport is a combination of entertainment and physical exercise. To play is a natural human instinct. Okay, so playing is a natural behavior of a human being. Okay, hence the history of sport began with the origin of mankind. See, for sport there is no technology is needed. Okay, sport is a part of human life, so it has been came since the origin of mankind. Okay, various games have been played since the beginning of civilization. See, if you have seen the last chapters, that art, entertainment, okay, mass media, information transfer, everything, so they need technology. Okay, they need some sources, they need some supporting equipments. But whereas sports is a human behavior, it's a human nature, it has started since the beginning of human origin, so there is no need of any technology of this. Okay, nowadays there are different technologies have been evolved. Different equipments have been come in the field of sport, but it's a natural behavior of a human being. Okay, so since the various games have, since our origin, the various games have been played. Okay, and since the beginning of civilization, there are so many games and sports. Hunting was indeed a way of obtaining food for the ancient people, but it was also looked upon as a game and entertainment. Okay, hunting earlier, we have seen the evolution of human from the apes to human beings. Okay, so there we have seen hunting was the first source of obtaining the food. Okay, later the hunting has become the sport to the ancient people. If you have seen the kings in the TV serials and all, they used to go and hunting for the and for the purpose of entertainment. Okay, so even hunting was considered as the type of sport. The ancient Indian literature and epic mention various games, such games as of dice, wrestling, horse and chariot race and chess. So dice is your dyut kida. Recently in Mahabharat you might have seen, okay, that dyut kida. Then other than that, dice, wrestling, the kushti, then horse riding and chess were the different games with in ancient people they used to play. Okay, so before proceeding, just I want to make sure that one difference between game and sport. Okay, what is game? Game may involve the physical and mental presence. Okay, for sport the physical presence is important. See, you can have a sport like cricket, okay, football, volleyball, you can have the games like chess, okay, and carom, and even the video games, whatever you play online or on the mobile phone, even they are called as games, not sport. Okay, the basic difference is that in games the physical and mental activity may involve, in sports the physical activities are involved. Okay, that's the main basic difference between sport and game. Okay, then let's proceed with the types of sports, that is your wrestling or kushti. Okay, there are number of training centers for wrestling and other sports. Then earlier days we used to call as Vyayam Shala of famous wrestlers like Jammu Dada and Manik Rao in Vadodara. Then Krida Vidyapeeth in Patiala. Then Swarnim Gujarat Sports in Gandhinagar. Then Khasbag Talim and Moti Bagh Talim in Kolhapur. Then Hanuman Vyayam. Then Prasarak Mandal in Amravati. Then Sri Shiv Chhatrapati Krida Sankul Balewadi in Pune. ठीक है, सो देयर आर द सेंटर्स वेयर द रिसलिंग कैन बी प्रैक्टिस्ड. ओके, सो व्हाट इज रिसलिंग एक्चुअली? दिस इज कुश्ती एंड दिस इज वेरी एंशंट टाइप ऑफ स्पोर्ट वेयर द पीपल यूज टू प्ले सिंस यू नो लॉन्ग टाइम लाइक फ्रॉम ओल्डन डेज. एंड इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द रिस एंड इन द लास्ट स्लाइड वी हैव सीन दैट द डिफरेंट क्रीडाशालाज और द सेंटर्स वेयर द कुश्तीज you know that can be practiced, and these are the few pictures of the champions who are the world champions, wrestling world champions from India. That's Geeta and Babita Fogat, so you can watch them in Dangal. Then Sakshi Malik, then Bajrang Punia and Sushil Kumar. So these are the Indian champions they are representing India in the international championship of wrestling. Okay, then sport, then we have Olympic competition. Okay, then sport and the Greek is a very ancient equation. Okay, the Greek were the first to standardize the rules of sports and organize them systematically. They started sports competitions of discus throw, horse and chariot races, wrestling and boxing, etc. The ancient event of Olympic competitions used to held at Olympia, the ancient Greek city. To be able to participate in Olympics and to be a winner is supposed to be the great honor for the sports person. See, if you see the different the Olympic competitions are, you know, very world famous competitions. Okay, so the sport and Greek are having a ancient equation. Means, see, to that level, the Greek people were the first who standardized the rule and they organized the competition systematically, and the different competitions held were discus throw. Even we do that discus throw in our school, isn't it? And horse and chariot races, wrestling and boxing, and the competitions were held in the city of Greek that is called as Olympia. Olympia is a city in Greek, that's why the name has come Olympic. Okay, and the winners. The winners in that competition, you know, if to become a winner in that competition to a person is of a great honor. Okay, so you know it will give you an impression. So if you have become a winner in that particular competition, then it will give you a exposure. See, to play games is very important for us. It enables us to overcome suffering and worries. See, what's the importance of sports? See, we have seen sports is a type of entertainment in which if you involve, you know, it will, your mind will get fresh and your physical strength will increase. It will increase your personality and everything. And also it enables us to overcome the sufferings and worries. So if you see, you know the games help us to relax and refresh our minds. Okay, that also in the last chapter we have seen. Games which involves lots of physical activities provide good exercise as well. Okay, so as if you want to become a good sports person, then your physical strength should be good, and it will access if you exercise well, then it will give you a good physical. If you are involved in a physical activity, so even your physical strength will be good. You know, games help in building the tenacious and strong body. Okay, so if you exercise well, if you eat well, so definitely you'll be having a strong body. Playing games also help us in developing courage, determination, sportsmanship. Games needing collective participation help us to develop a sense of cooperation and team spirit. It also help in the developing leadership. What's the importance of sports? See, okay, we have seen it's a type of entertainment where mind will get fresh. You are involved in the physical activity. your physical strength will improve, okay, and your personality will improve, and other than that, it will increase your time, you know, it will help you in developing the courage, okay, then you will not be hesitating or you will not be worried about any of the, you know, hurdles coming in your sport or in your life. Then you will be having a sportsmanship, a sportsman spirit. What sportsman spirit? That is, when you play a game or a sport, so you have two results, either one is win or lose. So it will give you the courage to face both, and it will give you the courage to cherish both. Okay, then games need collective participation and develop the sense of cooperation. If you see in a team, then the patience is very much important, then cooperation between the team members is very important, okay, and building the team spirit, and for that you should have a good leadership quality, the patience, time management, team management, okay. So these all will be developed by once if you involve in the sport. Time management also is very important. You will be given particular time in that you have to finish it, okay. Then you have time after time management, team management. The disputes between the team members should not happen. If the team members only quarreling with each other, then how can you defeat the other team in front of you, isn't it? Then the if you see some types of sports, if you are going to see further, there you have skydiving, scuba diving, where the courage is needed, you know. So it will improve all your capacities, okay. Then you have the type of sports, that is your indoor games and outdoor games. See, as the name itself implies, the indoor games. Indoor games are played within a closed environment, and a number of them are played by sitting at one place. See, usually as the name itself implies, indoor games. Matlab, the games which are played with the closed environment, and many of the games are usually by sitting at one place, like you have carom, chess, okay, card games, etc. They include chess, card games, games played with the guesses men and the dice, carom, etc. So these are the indoor games which are played under the closed environment, and usually if you see, they can be played by sitting at one place. The game known by various names as, see, this Kachyavadya and your Chokabara. Kachyavada are the stones kind of thing, and the Chokabara is, usually it's played in, we know that Chokabara, the name, or the common name we have. As Indian Ludo is very popular among Indians. Okay, so this is an Indian Ludo type of game, where you can have tamarind seeds you can throw, having the 25 squares on a table, okay. So that is Indian Ludo. The game known as Sagar Gote, played with a bunch of seeds or stones. So this is very famous, you know, the olden days people, they used to play the 5 stones 9 stones. They are called a Sagar Gote, by lifting one up, throwing one up, and lifting the remaining stones which are located in the bottom. So the people, maybe your mother or your grandparents may be knowing the Sagar Gote. Okay, is usually played by girls. There is another game known as Bhatukli. See, Bhatukli is a playing house which is very, very common in Indian houses, where all the girls used to play this. Bhatukli is playing house, which is usually played by girls. However, all the members of the family can also participate in it, especially in the mock wedding of girl doll and a boy doll. It is an occasion of family celebration. And if you see in villages nowadays also, girls, by picking a doll with them, and they play this by cooking, and they organize the marriage ceremony of the girl doll and boy doll. They do the entire ceremony, you know, they cook, they eat, as if they are, you know, running a family. So this is very famous, you know, game, which, so if you see, I have collected some pictures of Sagar Gote, where the people are playing with some stones. Bhatukli, where these are the toys with which the girls play. Then we have indoor games of carom, cards, chess, and Ludo. So these all are indoor games, okay. So the question can be asked, like, you know, write about your favorite game. or indoor games. So there you can write about this. Then you have outdoor games, and outdoor games are categorized into two, that is your Indian sports and international sports. So Indian sports are, let us see what are these. Indian games includes Langdi, Kabaddi, see that Attapatya, then Kho Kho, etc. are the Indian games, like Marbles, Lagori, Vitti Dandu or Gilli Danda, and Bhingari, that's Walls, then Bhavre, then Fugdi, then Zimma are quite popular. So these are the games. Usually, see, nowadays also we can play Kho Kho. You can see the people are playing Kho Kho. The competitions are been held on Kho Kho and Kabaddi. But other than that, this Langdi, you can play on one leg by jumping with one leg. You know that name. Now you know that game. Like then you have Lagori, which you play in the school. Then Vitti Dandu or Gilli Danda. Okay. Then Bhingri, that is, then Bhore. Okay, Bhore are the tops, the yo-yo kind of things. And Fugdi, Zimma are the popular. Okay. So these are the Indian games. Then you have international games. This includes badminton, alternatively spelled as badminton. Then table tennis, hockey, cricket, football, golf, polo, etc. Among outdoor sports, running races are the popular all over the world. Then sprints or short distance running race are usually arranged for 100 to 200 meters. There are middle distance and long distance races also, and marathon for the long distance racing also can be done. Okay, so in India we have very fun kind of Langdi, then you have Gilli Danda, then you have Lagori, okay, Kho Kho, Kabaddi. These are originated in India, so these are Indian games. So international games are, we know this, badminton, table tennis, hockey, cricket, okay, football, golf and polo. Okay, so other than that, running race is very common and it's very usual, arranged in everywhere. 100, 200 meter, middle distance, long distance and marathon. Okay, nowadays even marathons are held in, the city wise also. Then you have other types of running races are hurdles and relay races. Then you have shot put. Okay, then discus throw, long jump, high jump, water sports like swimming competitions, water polo, rowing, and the sports that combine physical exercise and acrobatics like Malkhamb, rope Malkhamb, then gymnastic, etc. are all included in the outdoor sports based on physical skills. Okay, so the swimming games also, then discus throw, long jump, high jump. Okay, then you have Malkhamb, rope Malkhamb and gymnastics. So these all includes your physical exercise. Then if you see the daily schedule of Lakshmi Bai, that's Rani of Jhansi, Her Highness was very fond of physical exercises. She used to wake up in the early hours and spend an hour or two ghatikas exercising Malkhamb, and then she had rounds of horse ride and a long elephant ride. Then 2 hours or the 4 ghatikas after sunrise she would eat khurak is a diet mean for enhancing the physical strength, and drink milk. Thereafter she had bath. So this means, if you see the daily schedule of Lakshmi Bai, this implies that she was very much fond of physical exercises and she was expert in Malkhamb and in horse riding and elephant riding. Okay, and if you see ghatika, one ghatika is your half an hour. Okay, then you have adventurous games. Ice skating, skiing, ice hockey, etc. are popular games that requires balancing skills. See, the adventurous games are very risky, and here so the games are being played for the sake of doing adventure. There are many other adventurous games which include rock climbing, gliding, auto racing, car and motorbikes, etc. Okay, so the motorbike, if you see, when I was young, very small, so there I have seen that Sachin Tendulkar was playing that car racing. Okay, so these are the adventurous, so these are not played for the sake of fun. So they are played as the adventure. Okay, so if you see, there are a few pictures of rock climbing, okay, mountain climbing, skiing. Nowadays, you have scuba diving also, parasailing, paragliding, okay, bungee jumping. Okay, so these all are the adventurous games. So we have seen now that we have different types of games. The game is a human nature, playing game is a human nature. So since the origin of mankind, people used to play the games, okay, as there is no technologies needed. So it includes physical and mental activity. So if you play the games, it will increase your personality. It will give you courage, team spirit, and everything. We have seen different types of sports also, indoor games, outdoor games. We have seen Indian games, international games, and everything. And after that, we let us see about our sports competitions. See, when we have sport, then the recognition should be done for that. The sports competition should be organized. Then sports competitions of various types is worldwide phenomena. There is a process. Worldwide, the different types of competitions are held. Sports competitions like Olympic, Asian Games are known as Asiads, Paralympics. The Paralympics are specially organized for the disabled people. Cricket World Cup, etc., are organized on regular basis. So regularly, you can see, the Olympic are periodic. Asian Games also come periodically. Then Paralympics and the World Cricket World Cup. Nowadays, you have 2020 World Cup. Okay. So they are very regular and very popular. Also, international competitions for many other sports like hockey, wrestling, chess, etc., are organized on a grand scale. Okay. Then you have in India, hockey and cricket are very popular. Even though hockey is a national sport, but along with hockey, cricket is also very popular. Nowadays, in gully gully, the people can play. The people are playing. Hockey is our national game. Competition of all these games are organized at local city, taluka, district, state, national, international levels. And sportsperson who perform well in national and international competitions have a good career prospects. Okay, so if you see, other than these also, like you know, okay, let us see this: the cricket, hockey, wrestling, chess, badminton, lawn tennis. Okay, so these the different competitions are held in a large scale. That is your local, city, national, international levels. Other than that, if you see, every year we go for sports. Other than that also, we can have Indian sports like Khoko, Kabaddi. So these for these sports also, the different competitions are held. But the Olympics, Asian Games, Paralympics, Cricket World Cup are very regular and very famous competitions. Okay. Then you have globalization of sports. Okay, so before this slide, whatever we had seen, on that the question can be asked, like write about the sports competitions. Okay, which is your favorite sport, and the symbol can be given of Olympic, and they can ask you to write about that. Okay, and even the question can be asked on the globalization of sports. The field of sport in the 20th and 21st century was naturally, see, influenced by the process of globalization. The international matches of various sports like cricket, football, lawn tennis can be watched on television in any corner of the world. Thus, the citizens of the non-participant country can also enjoy these matches. For instance, the World Cup winning match played by Indian cricketers was watched by cricket fans all over the world. Sports fans scattered all over the world have significantly affected the entire structure of sports economy. Fans watch the matches for entertainment. Industrial and commercial companies look at it as good opportunity to advertise their wear. The retired sportspersons also have an opportunity to participate as commentators. See, this is what, first let us focus on globalization. What is globalization? The global exposure you can get. See, if you have seen the different types of the competitions which are held, so nowadays, if you see the different competitions which are held somewhere in the worldwide, the India goes to England. There they play the match. They go to Sri Lanka. They go to Australia. Okay, but there means it is the sports people are not restricted to one country. सी दे आर गोइंग आउट एंड दे आर प्रमोटिंग द गेम, इजंट इट? सो व्हेन दे आर प्रमोटिंग द गेम एंड मे बी देन दे आर गेटिंग अ ग्लोबल एक्सपोजर. मे बी वी ओनली वी मे बी नोइंग द विराट कोहली बींग एन इंडियंस, एंड इफ वी इफ ही माइट हैव नॉट गॉट द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू प्ले ऑन द ग्लोबल साइड, नो बाय गोइंग आउट एंड प्लेड, मे बी द अदर पीपल माइट नॉट बी नोइंग हिम. सो वॉट आई मीन टू से, वेन यू गो आउट एंड प्ले देन यू विल गेट अ एक्सपोजर, देन द ग्लोबल वर्ल्ड वाइज पीपल विल कम टू नो, दैट इज योर ग्लोबलाइजेशन, इजंट इट? देन डिफरेंट मैचेस ऑफ क्रिकेट, लॉन टेनिस, ओके, एंड द हॉकी आर बीन प्लेड, दिस रोनाल्डो, ओके, हु प्लेज द फुटबॉल, देन वी हैव फॉर लॉन टेनिस रोजर फेडरर, ही इज नॉट फ्रॉम इंडिया बट इन इंडिया ऑल्सो ही इज हैविंग गुड फैन फॉलोइंग, इजंट इट? सो दे हैव गॉट द ग्लोबल एक्सपोजर. Then the non-participants, participant, the fans can also watch them enjoy their game or sports by sitting at one place. You can watch on the TV. When India won, like in the cricket match of India may not be only seen by Indian, but it can be watched by so many people global worldwide. Okay, and it has you know. Globalization has significantly affected the entire structure of sports economy. Economy, see, if you organize the cricket match of India, Australia and India, then even Australian fans come to India to watch movie, sorry, to watch the sport, cricket, isn't it? And if the India-Sri Lanka match is organized in Sri Lanka, then Indian fans, they go to Sri Lanka. So with that, their tourism will increase and definitely it will support their economy, isn't it? Then industrial, they can have the commercial advertisements. If you see the including their uniform, the posters, cutouts and everything promoting the sport, the commercial companies look after the good opportunity for expanding their, you know, the business. Then retired sports persons can work as the commentators. So the thing is that when we have sports, when we do globalization, definitely it will give you the importance. You will get a global exposure. The people will come to know you worldwide. Okay, then it will affect the economy also, as it will affect the sport person economy personally, then the industrial economy and the television. Okay, then even the retired people can give the commentary. So it will give the work opportunity as a commentator. So nowadays, you know, Sehwag is, you know, working retired person, Sehwag and Ganguly. Then game materials and toys. So we have seen the different types of sports are being played, games are being played, the different competitions will be organized, how it affects the you know, economy and the physical strength and personality and everything. And to play the game, some materials are needed, some toys are needed. So that we are going to see in this now next. The means and equipments for the entertainment and education of children are called toys. What are toys? You see, toys are the equipments, are the, you know, the things which are meant for the entertainment and education of for the children. Clay toys have been found in archaeological excavations. These toys were fashioned either by hands or by using molds. Dolls are mentioned in the ancient Indian literature. A Sanskrit play by Shudraka is named as Mritcha Hakatika. It means the clay art. See, the toys are as the playing game or a sports is an integral part of human life. So since the origin of human civilization, the different types of sports being played, games being played. So the toys have been found from those times also. Like, you know, the archaeological excavations have found so many toys. Okay, the dolls are, you know, nowadays like everybody's house are having dolls where the children play with that, isn't it? Then the toys and the history. Toys can throw a light on history and technological development. We can also get the glimpse of religious and cultural traditions through them. So if you go to the different places, there the different toys can be found. Okay, and those types of the toys are made either with hand or with the molds. And if you see it, so they can give you the you know, the glimpse of their religious and cultural tradition. See, as a part of tradition, Diwali celebration in Maharashtra, see, model forts are made, clay images of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj and his soldiers, and also people and some animals are placed on these model forts. This tradition keeps the memory alive of important role of forts in the history. So during Diwali in Maharashtra, the different games being played. So on this, I think last year the question was asked. Okay, the toys and history. And there you can give the example of this. So if I give you the general example, you know, so there I can give you the example of Krishnashtami. Okay, earlier we used to play. What do you do in Krishnashtami? So Krishnashtami, there we the clay toys, the clay models can be done, where Krishna, his family members, the devils which he killed. So by which you will come to know the history, who was like, you know, mythological history. Okay, so what I mean to say, the different toys which have been developed, so they give the glimpse of your religious and traditional cultures. Okay, so this you can give the example. This tradition keeps the memory alive of important role of the forts and history in Maharashtra. An ivory doll made by Indian craftsmen was found in the excavation of, see, Pimpli. The ancient, an ancient in Italy, Pompeii. An ancient in Italy. It is dated to the 1st century CE. This artifact throws a light on the Indo-Roman trade relationship. Thus, the toy found in the archaeological excavation can tell us about the culture contacts between men, the nations in ancient times. So this is what, like, you know, the in archaeological excavation, the Indian toys are found in Italy. So this means, so it will see, archaeological excavation are found where which you can study about the history. So there, if you have found the different toys of Indian toys in Italy, means Indian people used to go to Italy for the trade purpose, for business purpose. So it will give you the light on that, that concept also. Then that literature and the movie on sports. So that we are going, we'll see in the next class. And related, the notes and the questions I'll give you on WhatsApp. And if you have any doubts, you can ask me on WhatsApp. Okay, thank you.